Good afternoon to one and all. I am R.V. Kiran, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering. Today, in this video lecture, I am going to explain you about the topic of laser interferometer, which is the last type of interferometers in the syllabus. So, I need to define briefly about the what is a laser. So, what is the working of a laser interferometer, and what are the principle of it, and what are the different applications of this laser. And this is my 23rd lecture regarding to the subject metrology. In the previous lecture, I have delivered the topics NPL flatness interferometer and NPL gauge interferometer. And today we are going to discuss about laser interferometer. So coming to the laser interferometer, so this laser interferometer uses the AC type laser as light source and thus used to measure large distances, and the laser beam wavelength is exact and pure for highly accurate measurements. So generally these lasers are used for the measuring the work pieces in the larger distances, and it has an exact wavelength beam which is used to measure accurate measurements. And the principle involved in the laser interferometers are the optical technique and the its digital electronics. So these are the two types. So first of all, I am going to explain what is a laser and what is the principle and what is the components used in this laser. So the word laser means, so the full form of the word laser, that is LASER, so that is light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. So this is the full form of the word laser, that is light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. So that is the full form of the word laser. And this is an optical source that emits the photons in a coherent beam, that is a straight beam. So it uses the emitted photons in a coherent beam size. And a device which produces any particles or electromagnetic radiations in a coherent state is called as laser. So that is the main definition. So a device which produces any particles or electromagnetic radiations in a coherent state, that is the stride state, is called as a laser . The example for this is atom laser. So the best example for this is the atom laser. And in most cases, the laser refers to a source of coherent photons, that is in the light or other electromagnetic radiations. And in the most cases, they refers to the coherent photons only, and this laser is not limited to photons in the visible spectrum, and they are not applied to it. And generally, these lasers are applied in the commercial, industrial, biomedical, scientific, and military applications. So these are the general applications of the laser, but it is used in the coherent state only. That is, we are using it in the coherent state with electromagnetic radiations in it. And these are the properties of the laser. So it has a monochromatic property, directionality property, and the coherency property. So first coming to the monochromatic property, it has only one color or one wavelength. So generally, these laser consists of only one color or one wavelength. And second one is the directionality. So directionality is the estimated light propagate length in particular direction. So it sees it in the particular direction. And last one, it is the coherency. So this coherency is the estimated laser lights which are in the phase and the same directions. So that is called as coherency. So these are the different properties of the laser. And next slide depends on the types of lasers. So lasers are usually classified in terms of their active medium, that is in the large medium. So major types of lasers are, first one is the solid state laser, second one is the semiconductor lasers, next one dye lasers, gas lasers, and excimer lasers. So these are the different types of lasers which you have used in the active medium. So this is the diagram of the laser interferometer. So it has different components in which it gets a light source, that is the laser. And it has a semi-reflectors, two semi-reflectors, which is, it can be reflected, which the laser can be reflected in the 90 degree position. And It has a moving unit and an amplifier and a digital counter to it. So these laser interferometers can be used for the measurement of small diameters as well as large displacements. So these can be used in the smaller diameters as well as the larger displacements also. And in the picture you can see the laser. So this is the laser. So the laser light is passing through the semi-reflectors. So these semi-reflectors are used to transmit half of the light and reflect the remaining light in this position. So the transmitted light is sent to the moving unit at the which touches the Q position and then reflects to the R position and then comes to the semi-reflector. And then the reflected rays is directly sent to the semi-reflector one and then to the photoions, then to the amplifier. So the reflected rays also sent to the amplifier, in which we can see the reading of the output and the digital counter. So this is the schematic diagram of the laser interferometers. See it for a while. So first see the schematic diagram. So this is the laser and which is fixed in the fixed unit. So this is the fixed unit and the outer layer consists of the moving unit, amplifier and the digital counter. So let's see the working of the laser interferometer. So the first, the laser light first falls on the semi-reflector P, that is in the P point, and is partially reflected by the 90 degrees. So this is the P position, which is partially reflected. And then it is partially transmitted to the point Q. And a portion of the light passes through the P. So a portion of light then passes through the point P and strikes the corner Q. So that is the, this is the corner Q, which is the moving unit there. And light is turned through the 180 degree position by the corner Q. So that is when the light strikes it to the straight point and then goes to the reverse end, that is the reverse end, that is 180 degrees position. and recombines at the semi reflector. Yes, so then it recollects at the semi collector, that is the semi reflector S point. And if the difference between these two paths of light, that is PQRS and PS, so PQRS and PS is an odd number of the half wavelength, then interference will occur at point S and the diode output will be at a minimum position. But if the path difference is an even number of the half wavelengths, then the photodiodes will be register maximum output. So if the length of this is the equal to the half of this length, then it is an odd number, and in this an even number, then the photodiodes will register the maximum output condition. So that is the working of these laser beams. Then each time the moving slide is displaced by a quarter wavelength and the path difference becomes a half a wavelength, that is PQRS minus PS. So the wavelength becomes a half a wavelength and the output from the photodiode also changes from maximum to minimum or any other thing. So that is the vice versa. So when the distance is being moved to another position, so that is the moving slide is displaced from the quarter wavelength and the path difference becomes half a wavelength and the output from the photodiode. So this is the condition where we have to be alert and the distances has to be covered. So each time this is moving in the displaced position by a quarter wavelength and the path difference becomes half a wavelength and the output from the photodiode also changes from the maximum to minimum vice versa condition. So this is the general working condition of the laser beam from meter. So first of all, this laser light is sent to the semi-reflector, which touches this semi-reflector at the point P, and then it is sent to the point Q, which is the moving unit, And the usage of this semi reflector is to transmit the half of the laser light and reflect the other remaining light. So by transmitting the light to the Q point, it has the 180 degree position in the C cube, and it sends to the QR position and then reflects to the semi reflector at S point, and then it comes to the amplifier and it is seen the measurement in the digital counter, that is the output condition. Next, we have gone to the different applications of the laser. So these laser considered to be a solution in search of a problem in 1958, and it has many applications. So first of all, it is considered to be a solution in search of a problem in the 1958. So when they are doing a problem and when they are searching for a solution, the laser light is obtained with a coherent wavelength, which is in the coherent state. And the different applications of this laser are, first one is the scientific applications, next commercial applications, medical applications, and last one is the military applications. So these are the different types of applications of the laser. And the properties like coherence, monochromaticity, and ability to reach extremely high powers allow for these specialized applications. So the properties include these specialized applications. So first one is the scientific applications. So in the first scientific application is laser spectroscopy. So in this laser spectroscopy we can use the laser in atmospheric physics and polluting the monitoring of cancer detection. So by detection of the cancer also we can use the laser spectroscopy condition. And this laser spectroscopy condition is used by the laser. Next one is the optical metrology. So in this optical metrology, the optical distance and optical temperature measurements, etc., can be verified by this laser. So the optical distance can also be measured in this optical metrology by the help of a laser. Next one is the optical frequency metrology. In this optical frequency metrology, it is used for the precise position measurements, that is high precise measurements. So for doing the accurate measurements or for measuring the accurate measurements, they are going to use these optical frequency metrology. So by measuring these metrological and measurement positions, the optical frequency has been taken. And next one, laser induced breakdown spectroscopy. So in this laser induced breakdown spectroscopy, solid materials can be analyzed. So these solid materials with statements can be easily analyzed by this laser. So whenever we releases the monochroma, that is the laser light with the coherent state, so it is directly induced into the solid materials in which they can be analyzed easily. And next one is the laser cooling. So in this laser cooling, the laser makes it possible to bring clouds of atoms or ions to extremely low temperatures. So it is used to make the clouds of the atoms or ions to extremely low temperatures. So at the low temperature, we are going to use this laser cooling. Next one is the optical tweezers. So these are used for the trapping and manipulating the small particles. So these small particles includes the bacteria or very tiny objects and dust, which are used in parts of the living cells. So whenever we are going to measure these living cells also by use of the bacteria, we can use it with the laser. And next one, we comes to the next scientific applications, that is the laser microscopes. In these laser microscope, it provides the images of the biological samples with very high resolution, often which is used in the three-dimensional position also. So whenever we are using these laser microscope, we are used to define these positions, and these by using the laser microscope, we use it to provide the image of the very little or very naked image of the biological samples with very high resolution. So by saying it, we can analyze the prosperity of these biological effects on the cells. So that is, we are using these biological samples with very high resolutions, and often it can be seen in the three-dimensional way also. So we are going to see it in the only, not only in two-dimensional, but also in the three-dimensional way. So that is very clear in the laser microscopes. So generally, regular microscopes have a standard element in high micrometer. And with this use of laser microscope, it can be seen it in the very high resolution elements. Next one is the optical fiber communication. So in this optical fiber communication, it has been extensively used for long distance optical data transmission, which relies on laser light in optical glass fibers. So this relies on the optical glass fibers, which is used for the long distance optical data transmission. And next one, it is the free space optical communications. In the free space optical communications, it can be used for inter-satellite communications, that is the inter-satellite standard units, that is communication development. And it is used on the based on the high power lasers and generating collimating laser beams, which propagate over longer, large distances with small beam diverges. So generally, these laser light has very small divergence than the other lights. So when you are going to differentiate it between the other lights, the laser light has very small beam divergence. So we can use it in the free space optical communications also. So these are the different scientific applications of the laser. And next we go to the next application, that is the commercial applications. So these commercial applications include the market purpose or in the commercial purpose by attaining the different types of methodological applications used in the market. So first one is the cutting, welding and marking. So generally these laser light has been used in the cutting sections also for very thin beams. So when you are going to cut a beam with high speed and you have the less time, you need to cut with the laser light. And welding also has been done with the laser light also. And last one is the marking. So marking is also done with the laser light. And next one, range finder or surveying. So surveying of a land has also been done with the laser light. So when you are marking it with the light sensors of the laser, and when you go through the borders of the land, and then it is going to be surveyed. Next one is the LiDAR or pollution monitoring. So this is another commercial application. So which monitors the pollution in some specific areas. So when you are going to monitor or collect the pollution report of an area, you are going to use this laser application by using the laser sensors in the outward area. And in the CD and DVD player also, we are using these laser light. Next one is the laser printing. So in the laser printing also, we are using this laser light extensively. So this laser printing has been extensively used in the commercial applications in nowadays. Next one, laser engraving of printing plates. So this laser engraving is used for the accurate measurements and for very high complex shapes. So for when we are designing a complex shape, we are going to engrave it with the laser engraving system of printing plates. So for printing plates, they are going to be extensively used of laser engraving. Next one is the laser pointers, holography, laser light displays. So in the streets, while we are going to streets in the evening section in the cities, there is the laser light displaying for any functions or any other thing. These laser lights have been extensively used. So for the shopping malls purpose and for the extensively covering up of the lights with the shopping mall is done by this laser light only. And it has the laser points meet where we can see at a very high distance, very long distance also we can see, up to 2 to 3 kilometers range also we can see the laser pointers. And next one is the optical communications. So they are also highly used in these optical communication sector. So these are the different types of commercial applications used by the laser. And next we go to the medical applications. So in the medical applications, first one is the cosmetic surgery. So these medical applications are highly using these laser treatment nowadays. So for using a quick treatment and very high successive rate, they are using these laser treatment. So first one is the cosmetic surgery. So these, in this cosmetic surgery, the laser is used to remove the tattoos or any other scar marks and stretch marks, wrinkles. Wrinkles means wrinkles. Next, birthmarks and heads. Birthmarks means putmarks. So that is the birthmarks and excessive hair. So when we have excessive hair also, it also can be removed from the cosmetic surgery by use of this laser. Next one is the dentistry. That is dental. In the dentistry, it is used to carry the removal and tooth whitening and oral surgeries. So they are highly used in the tooth whitening section only. And next one, dermatology, which refers to the skin. So it is highly used for the treatment of acne and skin cancer by PDT. So that is the process of doing the treatment. It is highly used in the skin cancer treatment also, that is laser spectroscopy. And next one, it is used in the eye surgeries, that is cataract and glaucoma surgery. So in the eye surgeries, they are used to remove the sight. So whenever you're having the excess sight, you are going for the eye surgery, they are using the lasers as the objectives. And next one is the cardiology for the heart, that is angioplasty and the vessel recanalization also done by the laser. And next one, neurology. So in the neurology segment, it is used to cut the or vaporize and coagulate tissue without mechanical contrast. So when you are going to cut directly these tissues or remove the tissues, we are done with the laser only. Next is urology. So it removes the kidney stones. That is, the removal of kidney stones is called as lithotripsy. So these are also can be done by the laser only. Next one, laser scalpel. So that is gynecology, urology and laparoscopy. So which is good done to the women section, that is a gynecologist. And last one, it is optical imaging. That is, it is the field of online monitoring and diagnostics. This is called the optical imaging. So these are the different type of medical application section in the laser light. And last one, we go to the last application, that is the military applications. So in the military applications, first one is the defensive countermeasures. So what are the IR countermeasure systems which uses the laser to confuse the seeker heads on infrared homing missiles? So that is the missile section. So that is used for the loading the missile sections and tracking the device of the missile. Second one, disorientation. So some weapons simply use a laser to distort a person, disorient a person, that is the disorientation, that is for removing the its body parts. Next one, laser guidance. So this is a technique of guiding a missile or other projectile or vehicle to a target by means of a laser beam. So when you are going to use these laser beams, it is a projectile for a missile or vehicle to be a target. So for achieving this target, these are going to be achieved. Next one, target designator. So this is the another military use of lasers, which is as a laser target signator by shown infrared onto the target. So when you are going to see the projector or see target the scene. So when you are going to set a target, this is arranged by the laser target signator and it is marked on the target. That is another use. So these are the different applications of the laser. So by this, I am ending the this section, that is the laser interferometers, and I have extensively covered all the topics which is used in the laser and for the useful of the mechanical students only, not for the other section of students. Other of, section of students can extensively study about the laser, that is the what is an AC laser and what is a DC laser and the other things. So by this I am ending this video lecture. Thank you.